Hello and welcome to the last part of the PIM Electrolysis Technology unit. To conclude this unit, we will introduce the concept of balance of plant and finally we will review the current market and future research. Let's see how the complete system of an electrolysis plant will be. The PIM water electrolysis cell or stack needs to be placed in a specific environment for effective operation. For example, it is necessary to provide water of adequate purity and to supply that water to the cell or stack in order to feed the reaction. It is also important to remove the excess heat produced by internal dissipation during operation at non-zero current density. It is required to maintain the level of water purity during operation and to recycle the flow of electroosmotic water. And for instance, to extract from the cell the reaction products and to treat them in order to adjust their chemical composition to downstream requirements. All these operations are achieved by a number of dedicated subunits that form together the so-called balance of plant. In the figure, we can see these different subunits. The PIM water electrolysis unit is still at the heart of the overall process. On the other hand, DC electric power of appropriate specification is supplied to the electrolysis unit by the power management unit. This unit first uses an AC-AC transformer to adjust the voltage level of the main power source to the specific electrolysis plant requirements, and then an AC-DC rectifier to produce the appropriate DC power source required by the electrolysis module. On the left, we have the purification system, where purified water is provided by the water management unit that takes tap water and performs several purification steps required by the process. During operation, the water is pumped through the stack by the water circulation unit, where online resins are used to maintain the required level of water purity. In this loop, we can find also a heat exchanger used to extract the excess heat released by the electrolysis unit. Besides that, hydrogen is released after conditioning in an oxygen purifier and water dryer units that form part of the gas conditioning unit. The electrolysis plant is placed under the automated supervision of the process monitoring unit for continuous operation and monitoring. In a PIM water electrolysis plant, there is usually no thermostat to adjust the temperature of circulating water. The plant is designed to operate at nominal current density and the heat produced under such operating conditions is extracted and dissipated to the surroundings via a blower. Usually, heat dissipation is the red determining step that dictates the maximum operating current density of the electrolysis unit. Here we have in detail the liquid gas separation unit and the purification unit. In the liquid gas separation, a purification unit is placed on the anodic loop as well as a heat exchanger to cool down circulating water and set nominal operating temperature. These units are placed at the exit of both the cathode and the anode. In parallel, the electroosmosis flow of water collected on the cathode side is transferred back to the anode at regular time intervals, or sent back to water treatment unit. As for the gas treatment unit, we have already seen that the hydrogen purification is usually included in the PIM water electrolysis plant. The level of gas purity is a function of the application and customer specification. Normally, the main impurities are oxygen and water. Oxygen can be eliminated by passive catalytic recombination. On the other hand, water can be eliminated by using a chiller of appropriate capacity and/or by temperature swing adsorption. The photograph shows an example of the gas purification unit in the Labder laboratory at the Polytechnic University of Valencia. The other figure below shows an example of the different losses that appears taking into account the whole system. As we can see, due to the electro-intensive character of the water electrolysis reaction, a 30% of the electricity consumption is taken by the stacks. It should be noted here that the efficiency of the PIM plant is constant when the plant is operated under stationary conditions. However, efficiency is a function of time when the plant is operated under transient power conditions. To conclude this unit, we will speak about the main suppliers, commercial development and applications, as well as the future research. Modern PIM water electrolyzers contain large stacks higher than 1,000 square centimeters and up to 100 cells per stack. The hydrogen market contains three main segments: hydrogen for different chemical applications in industry, hydrogen mobility, for example, as refueling stations, and hydrogen for energy storage, for example, medium-scale systems which are required for local needs and grid regulation, and large-scale systems for seasonal storage of renewable energy sources. In terms of cost, hydrogen of electrolytic grade cannot compete with hydrogen from methane. The main advantage of water electrolysis is the process flexibility and the possibility of on-site modular production. If oxygen can also be used in a nearby process, this is a further advantage. However, if the main power source is coming from a renewable energy source, then storage units are required. On the other hand, hydrogen refueling stations for mobility applications are seen as an emerging market for which water electrolyzer can provide an alternative solution to conventional steam methane reformers. In the table, we can see the state of art of the different characteristics of the PIM electrolysis technology, the target value to be reached between 2020 and 2030, and the ultimate goal values. In current state of the art, PIM water electrolysis technology is already an efficient process. Enthalpic efficiencies up to 80-85% calculated from the higher heating value of hydrogen have been demonstrated at laboratory scale at 1 amps per square centimeter. Like any other technology, PIM water electrolysis has certain limitations. The main drawback for market application comes from the fact that for larger electrolyzers, for example, a minimum of 10 kg of hydrogen per hour is required in the short term to supply hydrogen in refueling stations, or that in these electrolyzers operating at multi-amps per square centimeter current densities with extended durability are needed. Therefore, market requirements are calling for systems down to the $500 kilowatt range. As an example of a commercial system, we have here the technical data sheet of the model EL400 from the manufacturer H2B2, which consists of two stacks that can generate 400 normal cubic meters per hour. Its operating range is between 10 and 100% of the nominal power, and it can generate hydrogen at a pressure of up to 40 bars. The model has a hydrogen purification system for the output of the stack, which comes out with 99.9% purity until it reaches 99.999%, which is the requirement for hydrogen use in PIM fuel cells. The stack consumes 4.5 kWh per cubic meter of hydrogen produced, although the consumption of the entire system is 5.1 kWh per cubic meter. Additionally, a water purification plant can be integrated to treat the water entering the stack. This system consumes 590 liters per hour when operating at maximum power. This electrolyzer has an interesting feature to be used as a renewable energy storage, as the start time is just 5 minutes from shutdown and less than 1 second from standby. As for the research, as at the stack level, enhanced performance will require the development of innovative materials for all cell components. The replacement of platinum family catalyst and expensive solid polymer electrolyte remains a challenging issue, but all cell components are concerned. Regarding basic research, current development focus on the reduction of iridium loadings at the anode by developing stable catalyst carriers or allowing ruthenium with iridium and an inert oxide, the development of novel metal-free catalysts, and the research on alternative solid polymer electrolytes. Concerning applied research, the focus is on the reduction of platinum loadings at the cathode using carbon carriers and or specific printing methods such as screen printing, and the surface treatment of titanium bipolar plates and current collector to reduce contact resistance. On the other hand, the main challenge for PIN water electrolysis are to identify and synthesize alternative materials with performances similar to those used in a state-of-art of technology. For example, the replacement of platinum with non-novel electrocatalyst. Different compounds have been identified as potential candidates for the replacement of platinum at the cathode. The idea developed by Millet and colleagues is to use mononuclear compounds that contain cobalt, nickel or ion active centers. Another challenge is to find new polymeric proton conductors for operation at more elevated temperature. Conventional solid polymer electrolytes are limited to operating temperature less than 90 degrees Celsius. Above this, the water swelling properties are affected if these materials are such that the water content becomes too high and membranes can lose their mechanical properties. Alternative perfluorosulfonated acid materials to NAFON, for example, a short side chain perfluorosulfonated acid such as Aquivivium from Solvay Company, are stable at temperatures around 120 and 150 degrees Celsius. In the figure, it can be seen the polarization curve of NAFION 115 and Aquivivium E87. We can see how, when temperature is near to 120 degrees Celsius, the behavior of Aquivivium is better than NAFION operating at 80 degrees Celsius. With this, we conclude the unit about the PIM electrolysis technology. Thank you very much for your attention.